Morning class. Today we'll start chapter number 5, heat. What is heat, children? Heat is a form of energy. In winter, we all sit in sun, na children, or near a heater. So what do you feel at that time? You feel warm, na? Why, children? Why do you feel warm? Because the reason is that we receive heat from the sun. We receive heat from the heater, which we can only feel, children. We are not able to see the heat coming from sun or heater. We just feel it. Heat is a form of energy, which we can feel but cannot see. Now, children, we all know that sun is a vast source of energy, heat energy. On earth, many things are happening, almost everything. It is happening because of the heat energy received from the sun. Like water cycle, heat energy makes water warm, then it evaporates and then it becomes water vapor and then it becomes clouds and then finally it rains. Plants use sun's energy to prepare their food through the process of photosynthesis, remember? So many things are there. We need heat for that. In daily life also, children, we observe that when we are rubbing our hands, our palms, they get heated. Why, children? Because while you are rubbing it, mechanical energy spent in rubbing the palms changes into heat energy. Similarly, children, when you are burning something, what is happening? Heat is produced. That is the chemical energy. You have studied all these things in your previous chapters also and in chemistry also, children. On passing current also, in the filament of bulb, it becomes hot. You can notice this thing also, children. When you touch a bulb, a glowing bulb, after some time, glowing it for some time and you touch it, you will feel that it is warm. Why? Because electric energy changes into heat energy. So all these examples, what are they showing us, children? They're showing us that heat is a form of energy. Now next thing comes, children. When we touch hot water, what we feel, children? We feel warm. And when we touch ice or something, ice or any other ice cream or something, what do we feel? Cold. Why it is happening? It is happening because we touch hot water. Heat energy flows from hot water to cold water, to our hand. So heat flows from hot water to our hand. And when we touch an ice cube, then heat flows from our hand to the ice cube. Okay. Means it goes from high to low. It is at high temperature, it is at low temperature. It goes from high to low, children. Now this thing only tells us that heat is a form of energy which flows from a hot body to a cold body when they are kept in contact. But when are they going to do this? When they come in contact. Okay. Now children, we also read in class 6 that the degree of hotness or coldness is a measure of a quantity called temperature. This degree, children, how much a thing is hot, how much it is cold, this is your temperature, children. When the body takes the heat energy, its temperature rises. And when a body loses the heat energy or gives out the heat energy, then its temperature falls down. Okay, then comes units of heat. Now, since it is a form of energy, children, so we are going to measure it in joule only, remember? And the symbol is capital J. Now, other units are also there, like 1 calorie. Now, what is 1 calorie? 1 calorie is defined as the heat energy required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water by 1 degree Celsius. When you have got 1 gram of water, you are heating it and it temperature rises by 1 degree. Now, what all amount heat required in this? It is your 1 calorie. And 1 kilocalorie, children, simple, 1000 calorie. Now our next topic comes temperature. We have just read about a bit temperature. Now in our daily life, children, we often come across hot and cold bodies. So we can say it is very hot, it is very cold, it is cold, it is warm, it is lukewarm, it is hot, very hot, simple. Now, but we don't have the exact measure. If we touch a lump of ice, children, we feel cold. We say ice is cold. Similarly, if we touch a touch water from a geyser, we feel hot. But how much Now this thing we are going to find out with the help of temperature, children. We have seen that our sense of touch is not reliable to find the degree. We cannot find the degree, the extent of hotness and coldness. We just can say it is very hot, it is hot, but how much? So in scientific language, children, hot or cold body, to measure their temperature, we use the term temperature to express hot or cold body. By saying that lump of ice is cold, we mean that ice is at lower temperature. When we say that this body is cold, it means, children, we are saying that the temperature is low. And when we are saying it is hot, then we are saying that the temperature is high. So now what is temperature, children? Again, the same definition. Temperature is a quantity which tells us the degree of hotness or coldness of a body. When a body is heated, when you are heating a body, the temperature rises, and when it is cooled, the temperature falls. Now, units of temperature. Generally, temperature is measured in degree Celsius, in short form, this class. Another units are Fahrenheit, and SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. But Kelvin, we just write capital K. Okay, now this finishes our one topic. Next topic I'll take in my next video. Thank you. Have a nice day.